A mind focus? No. Hello. Wait, if I do this, I have to squat to be in the frame. It's horrible. If I don't squat, I'm like this. Do you like my sweatshirt? I like my sweatshirt. Anyway, hi. Hello. Welcome back to a new vlog. This is a 24-hour marathon, even though I kind of cheated and started yesterday. But like, I'm reading Chain of Iron. This monster is 588 pages long. So if I want to finish it by tonight, I have to start early, you know? So I've read 111 pages today, already breaking my heart. But anyway, first of all, yes, this is a 24-hour marathon. My friend Clara is organizing the Spring at Notre Dame marathon challenges. Go on a walk. I'm going to the beach this morning. Like, that's why I'm talking now, because I have to go and prepare and live. So go on a walk, that will be done. Drink a cold beverage. I prepared a coffee that I put in the fridge, so I will be able to have a nice coffee. To show us a good cool outfit, that will be done, even though I'm going to freeze my ass at the beach, but it's fine. Share a show or a movie which gives you cottage core vibes. Guys, if you know which movie I'm going to talk about, comment in the comment section which movie it is. I'm pretty sure a lot of you will know, but why did I do this? And last challenge is bake something. We'll see. Okay, we'll see. As I was saying, I'm reading Chain of Iron and 111 pages in, started yesterday. It's going to be fun. I'm going to die. I swear I'm going to die. I'm listening to the audiobook at the same time I'm listening to it and following along with the book, which is amazing. Even though I think I would read it a bit quicker if I weren't listening to the audiobook, but like just a tiny bit quicker. But the audiobook is helping me focus a lot more, because I've had problems focusing when reading lately. Being able to listen to the audiobook and follow along is just helping me focus on the book and actually reading the book. So I think this is how I'm going to read Chain of Iron, and it's so far it's amazing. I'm loving the narrator of the audiobook. She has a lovely voice, and she takes some like kind of different voices for each character, so it's nice. So yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to get changed because I have to leave in 10 minutes. Everything's fine. By the way, it's 8:50. Didn't tell you this. It's 8:50. I'm drinking my coffee. Am I awake? I'm not sure. But I have too much chaos energy this early in the morning, so it's going to be fun. So it's a bit past 3 and I did a live show with Carl and I read a few pages. I want to do a reading update. I'm on page 254, so I've read this nearly halfway through the book. And yeah, I thought I would do a little reading update, as I put cream on my finger because I don't know if you can see, but I got bitten by a gnat. So I went to the beach, as you say, it was really nice. I just had to come back earlier than everybody else because I was doing the live with Clara and it was a really good time. It's such a lovely day today. I read a little bit on my balcony. How do I get this open? Oh, here. This is how we do it. But yeah, so what I've been doing, as I told you, is listening to the audiobook while I was in the bus. Didn't read much because I get motion sickness. So I just listened to the audiobook, and then during the live, I read something like 30 pages, like it was just a 30 minute reading sprint. I'm trying to get this open. Fuck, why is it so hot? Oh, smart. So yeah, nearly halfway through it and it's getting intense. I'm a bit scared of what's going to happen, not gonna lie. Yeah, I feel like reading the audiobook is very helpful because I'm just so anxious about the story, about these characters, that if I were not listening to the audiobook at the same time, I wouldn't be reading as much, because like I have this bad habit of just stopping when I get anxious, so I don't read, I put the book aside. But I read the last 60 pages on my own without listening to the audiobook, which is also nice, like I read a little bit faster. But I have a few things to do on my laptop that don't require me like to read or anything, so I'm just going to listen to the audiobook while I do this. It's a bit hard to explain my feelings without spoiling anything, but let's just say that miscommunication is the true villain of the story. That's all I'm going to say. Like, miscommunication, fuck it. Like, I knew things wouldn't be all perfect and ooh, everybody's happy, because that's the middle book and we all know how Cassie loves to have us in pain and during the middle of the book. So I knew it wouldn't be all flowers and happiness, but I'm anxious, you know, I'm just anxious. I'm not sure I will finish it today. I don't know, I feel like there will maybe come a point where I will be too tired, and if I feel like if I push myself, I won't enjoy the book as much. So we'll see, maybe I will have 200 pages left, I don't know, we'll see. But yeah, I just don't want to push myself and not enjoy the book to its fullest, because I was dumb and pushed myself. So we will see, but if I stop reading this book, I will switch to another book. It's such a pretty day. I'm glad I was able to go to the beach and enjoy this really nice weather. Also, I was able to walk nearly 5 kilometers. So that's pretty nice. And I had a milkshake, as you saw. So good. It was an hazelnut milkshake. So good. And I just had iced coffee, so I'm just having a nice day. So it's 6:15 and I just got back from a little walk with Grace, and I'm on page 310 of Chain of Iron, and I think I'm going to stop here for today. I feel like if I read it in its entirety today, it's not going to be as good as if I had taken my time. Also, I'm getting very anxious, so I just need to put the book aside for a little bit. But I still read more than half of the book, so I'm very happy with it. And I started The Wolf and the Woodsman. I'm on page 18. My bookmark is a pen. I know, it's a knock I got from Delver UK, and it's coming out on June 8th. And I really loved the first chapter. It was really good, and I feel like this book has the potential to be a 5-star. I just
I feel it, you know. It's 30 minutes later, but I've just realized that I didn't tell you about the Kadejkor movie that I recommend. If you've guessed it, good job. If not, it's Little Women. I just adore Little Women, be it the book or the movie, like the 2021 or the miniseries. Recently, I've watched the 1995 movie. I'm not a huge fan of it. I feel like it's just a movie about Joe and it's not that great. Like, they added things to the story that didn't need to be there, but they took things from the book that were essential to the story. So not the greatest fan. I love the way the actors portrayed the characters. That's not the problem. I just think the script wasn't great. But I also watched the BBC miniseries. It's incredible. Loved it. But my favorite still remains the 2020 movie version. So if you haven't seen Little Women, either watch miniseries or the 2020 movie and enjoy. Have fun. So it's something like 9:30 and this is going to be the last clip of me talking, and I just wanted to recap what I've read so far and what I'm hoping to read before I go to bed. Let's do with the one I currently have in my hand. I'm still reading The Wolf and the Woodsman. So this is a story inspired by Jewish mythology and Hungarian history. And although I'm only 37 pages in so far, I'm really liking it. I'm liking the writing style. I'm enjoying your main character, and as I said, I have a very good feeling about this book. Hopefully I will be able to get to page 100 before I go to bed. And as I told you, I'm a bit more than halfway through A Chain of Iron. I'm on page 100. No, I'm tired. I'm on page 310 and I'm loving it. I'm just very stressed, so that's why I had to stop. It's not going to be 5 stars, even though I gave Chain of Gold 5 stars. This doesn't feel like a 5 stars, like I'm a bit too frustrated with some characters and the way they're acting. And I feel like there is unnecessary miscommunication in this book. Like, it's just creating problems for the sake of having problems. But anyway, I still love the characters. I haven't seen much of my favorite character so far, who is Thomas. So anymore, like, Thomas and Alistair are my two favorite characters in this trilogy, although I fucking adore James. And weirdly enough, I'm really liking Grace's chapters, which I wasn't expecting because I'm not her biggest fan. But I love seeing her character development, and I love seeing the reason why she is the way she is. It's very interesting. So I'm shocked I'm liking her chapters. But yeah, honestly, I'm liking all the chapters. I'm liking all the point of views. It's just a good book. Not a 5 stars, but it's a good book.